Thomas Edison created new light with the incandescent light bulb. Albert Einstein opened a new era in time and space. And the Wright brothers realized the dream of human flight. The great changes of the world have always been led by eccentric scientists and 600 years ago, in Joseon times, there was a scientist who changed time. His name was Jang Yong-shil. He created the sundial and the water clock. In volume 61 of the Sejong Shilluk, there is a story about a government slave in Busan who was particularly talented at making agricultural equipment. Jang Yong-shil was famous for his dexterous hands. Anything that was required would quickly appear from his workshop. Yong-shil was a loner in his neighborhood, and people treated him as an outsider. But one person took an interest in him.
Yong-shil아! Yong-shil아! 너 한양으로 간대.
내가 한양으로?
자네가 장영실인가?
네, 제가 장영실입니다.
어서 짐을 꾸리게. 나랑 같이 한양으로 올라가야겠네.
네? 한양으로요?
공굴러 가는 거야, 자네.
1421, the third year of King Sejong's reign. The new king was worried. Joseon lacked astronomical technology. The bureaucrats could not do their jobs correctly because they could not tell time. The people of the kingdom fared not much better. Thus, Jang Yong-shil was called to the palace. King Sejong was gathering the nation's most talented scientists in his palace. King Sejong wanted to create astronomical tools and timepieces using Joseon's own technology for Joseon's future. The scientists were sent to China to study. Jang Yong-shil's first task was to create an accurate timepiece. The sun's shadow had been most widely used to tell time. Jang Yong-shil built the Yangbu-il-gu, a sundial. The sundial is semicircular with four legs. The Yangbu-il-gu divides the sun's yearly path across the sky into 24 15-day seasons. Around June 21st, when the sun is highest, it is Haji. 7 perpendicular lines were drawn, and people could read time by comparing the line to the sun's shadow as it moved west. The principles are in accordance with the sun's diurnal motion. As daylight hours decrease with colder seasons, the shadow becomes longer. The sundial was more scientific and systematic than any other timepiece made.
그 앙부일구는 그 천상에 운행되는 모습을 그대로 반영한 오목 해시계입니다. 그래서 아주 정밀한 과학의 우수성이 있습니다. 그리고 그 사용하는 장소가 표기가 되어 있는데 한양의 북극고 38도 소라고 이렇게 궁중에서 사용하는 것에는 표기가 되어 있습니다. 그것은 우리의 그 자주적인 시간이라든가 자주성을 아주 강조하는 그런 모습을 우리가 볼 수가 있습니다.
But the sundial had its limits. On cloudy days, the sundial was useless.
야, 시바, 너 지금 해가 중천에 떠는데 지금 뭐 하는 거냐 여기서?
너 지금 시바 뭔 소리 하는 거야?
하늘을 봐, 해가 어디 있어?
장 영실 began thinking. How could people tell time without the sun? King Sejong also realized the necessity of a timepiece that did not depend on the weather and ordered Zhang Yongshu to create a new clock. Zhang Yongshil spent some time working on new ideas. Finally, he found what he was looking for at a stream. Water. Water could be used anytime, anywhere. The problem was that a precise amount of water had to be released at precise times. And that the water had to be connected with a time signaling device. Finally, a new time signaling system was created. The Jagyongru was the first water clock and used a very complex mechanism that included pumps, measurement buoys, props, and devices for transmission and time signaling. The principles were detailed and scientific. When water is released from the pasuho, it enters the susuho, and the measurement stick comes up. The buoyancy pushes aside steel marbles to tell time. This is the focus of Jagyongru.
Jagyongru는 여러분들이 잘 아시다시피 물시계와 시보장치로 구성이 되어 있습니다. 그 시보장치의 특징은 바로 이 자격장치입니다. 이 자격장치는 구슬을 낙하시켜 가지고 그 에너지를 갖다가 얻어서 시보 인형들이 종을 치고 북을 치고 징을 치고 그다음에 이제 그 인형이 이제 전시되도록 하는 이제 그런 힘을 얻었는데 이와 같이 특히 이제 그런 그 구슬을 이용해서 그런 그 시보 장치를 작동시키는 방식 요것이 바로 우리 그 자격 장치의 핵심이죠.
The buoyancy is delivered to the lever and marbles and the marble falls to deliver power. Then three wooden dolls hit a bell, a drum, and a gong to signal the time. Most important is the connection between the time signaling device and the marbles. A large marble is controlled to indirectly control the signals.
그 자격 장치는 계수기 장치라 카운터 요즘 전자회로에서 쓰는 이제 카운터에 해당되는 겁니다. 그래서 이제 쉽게 얘기하면 이제 우리는 벌써 15세기의 기계식 그런 계수기 현대화된 아주 그 첨단 기술이 이제 그 컴퓨터에 많이 쓰는 것들이에요. 이제 그런 걸 갖다 이미 이제 발명 그런 걸 보면 우리가 중국 물식의 그런 그 전통을 이었지만 그걸 갖다가 훨씬 이제 그 혁신시킨 거죠.
The water clock was more precise and scientific than any timepiece made in any other country. It was more than a clock. It was time itself. From the 16th year of Sejong's reign, the Jagyeongru was used as the standard clock. King Sejong rewarded Jang Yongshil's hard work with the post of Hogun, or Admiral. King Sejong had wished to become independent from China and create a new framework for Joseon. Jang Yongshil wished to help his people with a more accurate clock. The sundial and water clock were the result of these men's noble efforts.